are in Wysock, just across the bridge from Towanda, at Tom Jennings Antique Store. And let's see if he's in. Anybody home? Hello there, Tom.
Hi, Joe.
Want to say hello to the YouTube?
Hi.
All right, this is Tom Jennings, and the name of the company?
Quicks Used Goods.
Okay, and what, you're typically into a lot of furniture, I understand?
We specialize in 20th century modern furniture.
Okay, you want to just give me a quick tour?
Sure. I'll take you right back here and show you some of the things.
And maybe you can describe what the types of furniture are?
We handle chrome.
That's what, sets. Is that 50s, late 40s? Or?
50s.
Yeah. All right. So you have a nice piano here for sale.
Nice piano.
Okay.
We have 50 some pieces of Haywood Wakefield furniture in the streamlined modern.
Okay.
This being a couple right here.
All right. There's one of those old style phones when he used to know how to make phones.
We have a lot of cornet ball solid birch furniture made in the 60s.
Okay. Do you ever do anything for movie sets or anything like that, or when you're doing movies?
We have sold some pieces to companies that do movie sets.
Okay.
We don't do it ourselves.
All right.
We have passed on that.
All right.
We have more here with white grill in here.
Well, this is
all Haywood Wakefield. And this,
and what kind of wood is this?
This is all solid birch.
Birch, okay.
This is their logo.
All right. Streamline, huh?
Streamline.
Except for lower drag, better gas mileage.
Yep.
And
they started producing it about 1935 and produced till the early 70s.
Okay.
We do some sculpture, like the piece of hanging on the wall.
Okay.
We also specialize in designer furniture. This is a piece of Hans Wegner, this rocking chair.
Hans looks like a big Kennedy rocker or something.
Mm-hmm. This is a piece attributed to Alto Alvar, made in Denmark. We like Danish style furniture.
Okay.
On the wall is a highwayman.
This one up here?
Picture. No, the one on the left.
This one.
The tree.
The tree, the palm tree. And it's called a highwayman?
Mm-hmm.
All right. And what's his, what years did he paint her?
Well, that's 1960s.
Okay, still around?
It was done in Florida. Well, there were 25 artists that painted under that name.
Mm-hmm.
And,
really?
Yeah, you know, from the east coast of Florida.
So how'd they get away with having 25 artists use the same name?
Well, they didn't. They weren't called that until later on in their career.
Okay. A lot of old bottles?
Old bottles, milk bottles. Handbooks.
Is this real blue glass here? What does something like that go for? That blue?
Well, that's a relatively inexpensive piece.
All right. Well, what does it go for?
$25.
Okay, that's like a bargain. And where are you located here in Wysock?
We're located in central Bradford County, which is in northeast Pennsylvania.
Uh-huh.
On Route 6, which is one of the original coast-to-coast highways in this country. We've been here 50-some years in this location.
Okay. Is there a street address?
No, it's just Main Street.
Okay.
You can't miss it.
That's right, we on the other video. All right, let's see. What year is this, roughly?
I'm not aware of that, but I would say it's late 40s.
Uh-huh.
Would be my guess. I
okay.
have no idea when that was made. It's kind of a nice print called The Lady in the Red Hat.
Who did this watercolor?
This was done by a friend of mine named Jorn Malik.
Okay, here's some art by Jorn
Malik.
Malik, and he's from where?
Switzerland.
Switzerland. Okay, and he did these two,
mm-hmm.
and he did this, which is quite a different type of style or technique, right?
Well, that's a watercolor.
Right.
These are acrylic over here.
Uh-huh. What's he most noted for, this type? This is very unusual.
I would think his watercolors are probably what he's most noted for.
Okay.
I cannot tell you. I haven't seen him in some time. I can't tell you whether he's still painting or not.
Alrighty.
He's a character.
And what's out here?
Well, this is where we have our what we call used furniture.
All right.
This is a variety of things going from turn of the century oak.
That looks like oak, yeah.
To 20th century Danish.
Okay.
In the meantime, we have mid-priced used furniture.
Mm-hmm.
We also deal in some upholstery material.
We have enough chairs. So what's your telephone number if they want to call and find out if you have something?
570.
Right.
265.
Okay.
3388.
Okay. All right, Tom. Well, thank you for the tour.
Thank you, Joe.
And
anytime.
I think it'll be interesting for people to see what you got here.
Come see us again.
We will. Bye.
Okay, so for what occasions do you come to the Red Rose Diner?
Every morning for breakfast, and most afternoons for supper.
Why do you like the Red Rose Diner?
The personality of the people who eat here, and the food.
Great, and why would you recommend the Red Rose Diner?
Because everybody's so friendly. Including the bar.
Perfect. Thank you very, very much for doing that.
Thank you.
Okay, Tom, you want to explain this one?
Well, this is a photograph of the Black Diamond, which is Lehigh Valley's fast passenger train. This engine was designed in the 30s by Donald Deske,
mm-hmm.
who was a famous designer of that time frame.
Okay.
Here's a picture of the railroad station in Sayre, Pennsylvania, which is the home of the Lehigh Valley shops.
All right.
Here's an interior picture of the shops
mm-hmm.
at Sayre when okay. they were working on engines. It was a big engine. Here's one of Lehigh Valley's diesels, which came into use in the mid-50s, 60s.
Okay.
And this is a bridge on the Erie-Lackawanna Railroad in Nicholson, Pennsylvania. It's called the Nicholson Viaduct.
I've seen that pictures. It's a pretty famous viaduct, right?
Yes.
Where do you get these things? I mean, how do you come about them? Or do these come in regularly, this type of things?
They drift in from time to time.
Okay.
We don't specialize in railroad particularly here, although we get a lot of call for railroad type mm-hmm. items, being that we're right on the main line of the Lehigh Valley Railroad.
All right, so you're located on Route 6 in Wysock. Just near the up from the bridge, the big bridge that crosses over. Right, was that about a mile or a half mile? Or
we're about a mile from the main crossing, the Susquehanna River.
On Route 6.
It's a major crossing in this part of Pennsylvania.
Okay, very good. Well, thank you very much.